Okay, so I think the last class which we had a few weeks back, we had done up to directivity. Okay? And did we solve problems in the last class on directivity? In the last class, did we solve problems related to directivity? Good morning, all. Right, so in the last class, we had defined that directivity at a given direction, theta phi, is defined as the ratio of the radiation intensity of the guest antenna at that given direction divided by the radiation intensity of an isotropic antenna. Given that the test antenna and the isotropic antenna are radiating the same amount of power. Now, for isotropic antenna, obviously there is no need to put theta phi because isotropic antenna, we have discussed, it radiates equally well in all directions. So, it doesn't mean, so the u is not a function of theta and phi for an isotropic. So, what is u0? u0, this is simply P rad by P rad is the total power radiated by the antenna. D theta phi can be also written as 4 pi u theta phi rad. Now, by directivity, we generally mean the maximum directivity. Okay? If nothing is given, then we assume that this is for the value of theta phi, which makes this value maximum. Okay? So D is 4 pi U max by D max is 4 pi U max by D. So if nothing is given, we assume that we need this. Is it okay? If nothing is mentioned about direction, you can very safely assume that what is meant is the maximum value or the value of theta and phi for which u is maximum. Right? Any questions so far? Anything? Any questions so far? Let us solve a problem. You will find many similar problems given to you as well. For an antenna, u is given as u equal to a0 sine theta. What is the difference? Since nothing is mentioned about direction, we assume that we have to find the maximum. Is it for isotropic antenna or general? What exactly is this? What exactly do you mean this? Can you try? It's very easy problem. Just for your reference, D is equal to 4 pi U by Arpit, what do you mean by this? I guess by this you mean that directivity idea. See, directivity in isotropic antenna is well known, is one. And it is same in every direction. Okay? So, for that, yes, the directivity of isotropic antenna is one for all directions. So, maximum directivity for isotropic antenna doesn't have any sense. No matter what value of theta or phi you choose, you will find directivity is 1. Because it radiates equally well for all values of theta. Okay? So it is true for isotropic antenna and general both. But for isotropic antenna, we don't bother that. Pi square A, okay? And I think you are right. Yes, absolutely right. Very good. Well done. That is the correct answer. Did anybody get this answer? This is the right answer. So what is, just 1 second please. Okay, sorry for that. U max. So what is U? So what is U max? Obviously, A0 is constant. And sin theta max is obviously 1. So that is A0. Is it okay? Now, what is P dad? P dad is the total power U integrate over the entire solid area, that is entire theta 0 to pi, pi 0 to 2 pi, that is A0 sin theta into sin theta d theta d phi. So this is A0 0 to pi. Sorry, you have found this one, the radiated power, not the directivity. Sin square theta d theta 0 to 2 pi d phi. Yeah, 4 by pi is the right answer. That is the 4 pi square by a pi square, that is the radiated power, P dad. Okay, so for that is the formula. So this is 2 pi. So that is 2 pi A0 into 0 to pi. Sin square theta d theta, what is this integral? Pi A0, 0 to pi, 2 sin square theta d theta. Now we know that 1 minus 2 sin square theta equal to cos 2 theta. 1 minus cos 2 theta, that is sin square theta. So this is equal to pi A0. 0 to pi d theta, 0 to pi cos theta d theta, the second integral is 0, so this is pi square A0. So P dad is pi square A0. What I think, that's what we have made. P dad is pi square A0. So directivity is U max, D max is U max by 4 pi U max by P dad. So that is 4 pi A0 by pi square A0. That is, pi. Is it okay? So this is in absolute terms and in directivity in dB. Actually, gain is that is scaling up. So, you will find many similar problems given to you in your assignment. So, this is the general way of solving. The only tough thing is that integration. Now, for some values of things, you will not find that integral very, very easy. For example, if you see the last problem, given as a bonus problem, then integral is a bit tricky. Any questions in our directivity? Any questions about directivity? The best reference for this is Balani's book. I have taken this entire lecture. I think this lecture and the next few lectures will be straight from the Balani's book. Also, you should go through the lectures by Balani. Because in that lecture, there are many things which I cannot read. I am not. It's not possible for me. Okay? So all of you should go through this. Any questions regarding the activity or we should move on? Anything you want to ask for the activity or we should move on to the next one? Yes, Yitika? What is in the left hand side of the last equation? This one. This one is directivity in dBs. That is 10 log base 10 of that directivity absolute. Okay. This directivity in dB. Actually, gain in dB is much more common. Next topic. Okay. So directivity is okay. So now we do the next topic is gain. That is much more. That is very similar to directivity. They are not the same. Gain of it. Right. We have studied gain of an amplifier. So what is the gain of an amplifier? That would be voltage gain, current gain, power gain, two things. So voltage gain is AV, that is V out by V. Current gain is I out by I, and this power gain is V out by V. Antenna gain is totally different from A, from the if I feed, I have an antenna, okay, and I am connecting some, I am giving some power to it. Do you think all the power which I am feeding to the antenna gets emitted? If I feed, suppose 10 watts to an antenna, do you think all 10 watts will be emitted? Why not? Some power will be absorbed by what? By circuit. Yes, there will be dielectric losses. Other things, that is a valid point. What could be other problems that we lose power? One of them, I think, we can discuss a lot in the lab classes. Another problem from which we often end up losing power. Any other mechanism from which we can lose power? Very common. We have discussed a lot about that in that course. Yes. And loss in resistance is very good. Yes, yes, I square and loss is very good. And transmission lines, why do we lose power in transmission lines? Of course, that I square R loss, what he is saying is there. Okay. Similarly, what you are saying that the loss you get by very good. In transmission line, there is one more thing for which we use problem. What is that? And to counter that, we did all those labs. The counter that we lossy resistance, we cannot do anything, right? It will be there. We cannot just reduce the resistance in that light. But there is one thing for which we all is lost, but we can do something. And that is data transmission rates. Actually, this should be the position. High impedance state. Yes, actually, that's right. So, why do we disturb matching? Why do we need to match the impedance? What is the problem if we don't bother about matching? We can match stub with transmission line. Exactly, but what is the problem if we don't do it? If we don't do what you are saying, what will be the problem? There will be impedance mismatch, okay, and there will be loss. Remember what we said, that PL was P0 1 minus that, this one. We write this the Laplace, remember? And what was gamma? Gamma was reflection coefficient, okay? So, for improper matching, gamma was reflection coefficient. So, if the matching is not proper, gamma is not equal to 0. So, PL is less than P0. So, this is another way we lose power, okay? And to counteract what you said is right, we apply matching. You can do stub matching or you can do matching any other method, okay? So, if the matching is not proper, we lose power. So, the three major ways in which we lose power are reflection losses due to mismatch, conductor losses, what Arpit said, and dielectric losses. I think that was said very well. So these three, they are the three major ways in which we lose power. Okay, and this gives rise to a quantity called Ankin efficiency. Not to be confused with Fermi. Antenna efficiency. This is given by eta z. Not to be confused with Fermi. Eta 0 is product of three quantities. ER, EC, ED. This is due to reflection losses. All of them are less than 1. Conductor losses, dielectric losses. Is it okay? If we feed a power of PT, to a transmitter, the radiated power PR that will be E naught times Pt. Do you agree? If we feed a power of Pt watts to the terminals of the antenna, some power what we discussed will be lost. The radiated power will be P rad, that is equal to epsilon naught times Pt. This epsilon naught is, I repeat, is not permittivity, it is the antenna efficiency. Okay? Let us write it epsilon F. Yes, we have got in confusion. Let us write epsilon F. So P rad is equal to epsilon F, yes, times Pt. Is it okay? Now from the definition of directivity, what we had, directivity was D equal to 4 pi U by P rad, right? This is how we define directivity just a few moments ago. Agreed? This we can write now, 4 pi U by EF times PT. Okay. Let us bring this EF on the left hand side. So EF D, that is 4 pi U by PT. We can write that. This quantity, EF times D, this is called G or the antenna gain. So, antenna gain is directly proportional to directivity, they are not same. So, is it okay? This is the antenna gain. And which quantity is more practical, antenna gain or antenna directivity? Yes. Gain, because it is easier to measure the power that is feeding to the antenna, not what is radiated. So, for a given antenna, it is, we find that in most of the places they use gain, okay, not direct. Because gain is, so what would be the gain for a receiving antenna? This is the gain for a transmitting antenna. What would be the gain of a receiving antenna? This is how we define the gain of transmitting it, right? We are feeding some power to the antenna. Obviously, a fraction of it is radiated. And this is how we define it. It is a direction, it is the maximum radiation intensity times 4 pi by. So, this is in terms of the transmitting antenna. What is the gain of the receiving antenna? This is. Okay. So, this is okay. And gain is often measured in dBi. dBi is dB over isotropy. If you see dBi anywhere, BDS ratio, this is mentioned as the gain of an antenna. This is very easy. This is 10 log 10. Now tell me, I have got an antenna whose efficiency is 0.9 and gain is 10 dBi. If Pt is 6 watts, what is Pt? 6 watts, option A, option B, 5.4 watts. Option C, 60 watts. Option D, 50 watts. What will be the answer? PT is 6 watts. Okay. EF is 0.9, gain is 10 dB. What will be PDF? Yes, right, all of you, 5.4 watts, right? Because it cannot radiate, the antenna cannot radiate more than 6 watts under any circumstances. There are a few active antennas where there are some I think diodes or something for which they have got some gates, but those things we don't. Okay. The antenna, if you are feeding 6 watts of power to the antenna cannot radiate more than 6 watts under any circumstances. Even the 6 watts is ideal is. Obviously, it part we can do it. Okay. Next. So, gain is okay? Any question regarding gain? Next is input impedance. Z in, just like any other circuit, it will be some R plus Z X. Okay. When the antenna is close to its resonant length, okay, resonant length is just a little bit less than lambda by 2. For a dipole antenna, which is radiating with a wavelength of lambda, the resonant length is little less than lambda by 2. If the antenna is at its resonant length, okay, then the X part is 0, we have only R. And we always want to burn the antenna ready at its resolution. Okay, because that's for which the X efficiency is best. Is it okay? If antenna is at its resolution, L that is slightly less than, L is almost equal to L lambda by 2. L is integer, not equal to 0. And lambda is the wavelength. Unfortunately, there were no lab experiments for this semester. If we had lab experiments, we had seen that in any lab, what we do? Everything, right? Resonant length is very close, like this 0.46 or 0.48 lambda. That way. So at resonant length, this X part is only R. At resonant length, Z in for a dipole antenna is around 7. It's a pure resistance. Is it okay? Right? There is another antenna called a folded dipole antenna, we will discuss later. Okay? Whose Zin is at resonant length is 4 times of that. Okay? And that antenna. Anybody has seen the old TV antennas? Let me see if I can find something. You have seen antennas like this? Anyone at rooftops? Now they are obsolete. When I was, I think, in a school, those antennas were very common. Okay. This type of an antenna, it is called an Yagi Uda antenna, named after the inventors. It's an entire setup. This antenna is 1200 rupees. The entire setup is called an Yagi Uda array, named after the inventors. This was invented in 1928 in Japan. So this is almost 100 years old. Note this one. This one. You see this one? This thing? The rounded thing? Can you see? This is a folded dipole. Only this. The entire structure of 5 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They form the Yagi array. This is called a reflector. Okay. This is called a reflector. This is the radiating element. And these are called gyrators. Okay. This is a folded dipole. And folded dipole is preferred as the radiating element over standard dipole because of this radiation resistance. Radiation resistance of folded dipole at resonance is around 4 times or 70. That is 290 ohms more or less. And the transmission line which feeds the antenna, that's impedance is 300 ohms. So it's very easy to match. Okay. That is why this type of folded dipoles are preferred over standard dipoles, because the radiation resistance is much closer to the characteristic impedance of the line which is feeding it. Is it okay? You will see Yagi Uda in details if we get it. Very interesting. This has a pattern, a very sharp pattern in this. Any questions? Any questions? Okay. So great, come back. Now we focus more on receiving it. Okay. I have an antenna like this. Right? And some signal is coming from a transmitting antenna to distance some distance. Is it clear, sir? It's not clear. Okay. So some electric field, so that is the EM wave. Okay. It has an electric field component and a magnetic field component which we have discovered. So the electric field, incident electric field is EI. Okay. And we measure a voltage here, V. So the effective length is simply V is equal to EI dot V. This AV is called the antenna. Okay, very easy. Any questions? Oh, 5 minutes, so at any instant.